This is, in my opinion, the best way to set up your projects for game development. And I would like to also see other people do it like me, so in this video, we will go through all the decisions that I took while making this setup. This is also what I used to make my Steam game, and how I set up all my projects, so I think it stood the test of time. Before we start, I will mention that you can find it on GitHub, and I even have spent the time to make a small documentation for it, and I also have videos guiding you to making a game in it if you want to try it out. We will first talk briefly about the CMake, and then about the code structure itself. So, this setup uses CMake. Don't worry if you don't know CMake. I just want you to know what I am doing here and why. I have a CMake tutorial though if you are curious. And while CMake can be and is annoying, I think that it is in part because people overcomplicate it. My setup is less than 90 lines of CMake, and the big advantages of CMake are that it is cross-platform, cross-IDE, and it allows you to easily add libraries. So, to open the CMake, don't generate your solution, that's dumb. Just right-click here, open with Visual Studio, and you are done. It will even regenerate the solution for you if you add a new file and stuff. Now, in the CMake, the first thing that I do is I link statically with the runtime library. This will make your life so much easier because if you don't do that, you need to ship your game along with the runtime. And why do that when you can just add it directly into your game? Next, I have to set up some things about GLFW to also link statically. And then I can import all of the libraries. Now all of the libraries are just cloned inside the repo. This makes it much more easy to work with them, to clone the repo, or to modify them, or to debug the project. You are not supposed to update libraries often mid-development anyway, so I like this solution. People usually install libraries globally with CMake, but that just makes it a pain to send the project to others. Plus, what if you need to modify the library for some debugging or have multiple versions? Nowadays, we have enough storage to just copy the libraries many times, and even some professional game dev companies do something similar. Next, I do this trick that basically adds all of the CPP files into the SRC folder to the project. So usually, people just add the files by hand, and like, come on, this is a mess. With my setup, you just have to add your file into the folder, and you are done. It can get easier than this. And you can even add subfolders. Just click cancel here, when Visual Studio asks you if you want the file to be added, because it is added automatically. If you click OK by mistake, just remove it from here. And also, just regenerate your project by saving the CMake or by deleting the out folder if Visual Studio doesn't see the changes. Finally, we have this macro here. A problem with using CMake is that the paths are just annoying. Opening the program from the debugger sets it a different path for the program, so you either have to not be able to debug or not be able to run the program individually. And I have seen people come up with so many over-engineered and horrible solutions. This solution just makes a macro that points to the absolute path of the resources. So you load your files like this. And to ship the game, you just set this flag to on, and regenerate your project by deleting this folder, and saving the CMake. Now the resources folder is relative to your exe, and you can ship your game like this. I also have this line that disables the console. I want to open it myself, so I can control when to have it open or not. In my case, I have it open in development mode, and I can report errors and logs, but in production, I don't open it and don't print errors and logs. And finally, I just link all the libraries. You can add any library you want, but I already have all you need to make a game including sound, rendering and networking. Let's look at the code structure now. The project is split into platform layer and game layer. I learned this by watching the Handmade Hero series, and basically, I keep the window opening logic and input separately from my game code. Here I have gamelayer.cpp, and it is where you write your program. You have your init, update and delete functions, and you can make your game nicely from here. You can get your delta time and it is nicely clamped so you don't get weird edge cases, and you can also access the input. I opted for immediate mode input, that basically allows me to ask at any time if a key is pressed, held, released or typed this frame. I can also get the type letters. This makes the game logic much more easy to write rather than using input callbacks. Yuck. I recommend you to also structure your projects like this. Now for rendering, I use my 2D library, but you can configure whatever you want. But if you want to use my 2D library, I just made a wiki for it, so give it a try. Now for developer tools, I have ImGUI with docking configured that allows me to easily add buttons and sliders to better test stuff. I even added this macro to remove the ImGUI implementation to more easily ship the game. Speaking of shipping a game, so I have these custom assertion functions called permaassert and permaassertComment that will always check for errors. It is made for things that should not fail, like loading OpenGL or loading textures. If it fails, it allows you to debug your program from there or ignore it. In a production build, however, and you do that by setting this flag, the option to debug or ignore is removed. A production build will also change the resources pass macro, as explained earlier. Now all you have to do is make sure you have a release configuration without debug info, and you can mill your game for production. And this is about it. If you want to try out yourself this setup, I have a video and I will soon release an even better full game in C++ guide, so subscribe to not miss that out. Share this video if you found it useful, and also, check out my Steam game that just came out. See you!